Hi, this is Robin Bremer. Website or blog is robinbremer.net. You can go there and get lots of free teaching and lots of posters that you can put on Facebook, lots of charts and things like that that are helpful. Anyway, today what I wanted to go over is I've been really studying. God told me to go and start in Matthew and go through the New Testament and notice all the times that angels were mentioned and what angels did. Because one of the questions I had for the Holy Spirit is, what is the difference in what you do as compared to what the angels do? Because when I'm praying, I pray. Okay, let me back up. When we pray, when Jesus taught his disciples to pray, he said, pray our Father who is in heaven, thy kingdom come. Father who is in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So the kingdom is what causes his will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. Because the kingdom is God's rule and reign. For example, let's say Princess Di was still alive, Princess Di and Charles, and they had a kingdom. So whenever they took new land or new territory, that would be the kingdom of Princess Di and Charles. And everywhere on their land would be their kingdom, their rules. And so when you say your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, well, God's kingdom, his rule is from heaven onto the earth. And that what makes his will done on earth as it is in heaven. So, for example, with Princess Di and Charles, their kingdom, they make the rules and they decide what happens and what didn't happen if they were kings, so to say, right now. But we know that's not true because Princess Di is dead. Anyway, my point being that the kingdom that we see in the Bible means God's government, God's rule, God's reign, God's authority. And Jesus prayed, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So what brings God's earth and enforces God's earth on heaven, like it on earth as like it is in heaven, is the kingdom. Okay, so I want you to establish that. Okay, then everything Jesus prayed was answered. When he told his disciples, pray like this, he wasn't saying say these exact words, but he's saying pray like this, because this is what I want to have done. So when Jesus went around teaching the kingdom, because we went from old covenant. Okay, let me start. This is kind of what God showed me this morning. I'm going in all different rabbit trails here. But what God showed me this morning is, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And he put man on the earth to have authority and dominion and rule. He said, subdue. We're creating man in our image and our likeness, and they have authority, dominion, and they rule. Okay, so man was what he called God. If you look at the scriptures, God on earth or Lord of the earth, meaning the master, the ruler of the earth. Okay, God delegated that authority to man. When man disobeyed God and instead followed the devil, then man delegated their authority, their dominion, their rule, their power to the devil. Okay, so here you got the devil in charge of earth now. But yet God said human beings have dominion, authority, and rule. And yet Satan, who is a spirit being, has now delegated authority to the devil. The human did that to the devil. So God has to come in here and make a legal entry so that he can once again take back authority and give it back to man. And the way he did that was by the blood. Instead of sacrificing their life because they sinned, he sacrificed an animal's life. Which in the process of time, allowed him to sacrifice Jesus as the perfect sacrificial lamb that fulfilled all of the Jewish laws. And when Jesus came to earth, lived a perfect life, just like Adam could have lived, in the same power, authority, dominion, and subduing that Adam could have lived, Jesus lived that with the kingdom. He went about teaching and preaching and showing the kingdom. The kingdom, God's power and authority, his will on earth as it is in heaven, is healing the sick, casting out devils, cleansing leprosy, raising the dead, and preaching the good news to the poor. Okay? That is the kingdom, God's authority and God's dominion. So that's what Jesus did. He said, okay, this is the old covenant. Okay, and the devil is the ruler of the earth because of what man delegated authority to the devil. So here is Satan as the ruler of the earth. In God's sovereignty, he gave earth to man. Man delegated it to the devil. Okay, so here is Satan, ruler of the earth. Here is God up here. And he gave earth to man for 6,000 years, 6,000, 7,000 years, whatever. And then man gave it to the devil. So God sent his son Jesus to become the sacrificial lamb over here. And he died a perfect, sinless life and became the sacrificial lamb. And because of that, he took authority and dominion away from the devil and delegated it once again back to man. Okay. So Jesus demonstrated the kingdom rule and God's will while he is on earth. Now, the part I'm getting to share all this, is that men, Christians, are now back in the original position that God put them on the earth to be in, to rule, subdue, and have dominion. But the problem is that the devil does not want to let go. So the devil is going to lie to you and deceive you and try to get you to not know your identity, that you are a son of God, a child of God, redeemed by the blood of Jesus, perfect, holy, and above reproach in his sight, because you are a recreated spirit. You are now alive in your spirit. You're a human being that you are a spirit being that has a human body and a soul. We live in our human body and our soul. When our spirit leaves, our body is dead, because our spirit, which has our soul, goes to heaven or hell, depending on if we accepted the free gift of Jesus. So all that said, so now when we know our identity and who we are in Christ, that we're a son of God, that we're empowered, when we realize that we carry the kingdom in us, the word of God says the kingdom of God is in you, in power. So the new covenant is about a kingdom. The old covenant is about obeying the law, because the law was the tutor to bring about and say, hey, look, you can't do this. You need help. You can't do this. I'm sending you help, but this is the best you can do for now. Follow all these laws, and then Jesus will come and he will fulfill the law for you. He will take away the law, and instead of, listen to this, this is, I'm telling you, like something God said to me the last 3 days, I'm like putting it all into one. This is really good though. He said, now I forgot my line of thought, what I was going to say. He said, what is happening today with today's Christians is we are following the law, the old covenant, because we do not know our identity. He says the old covenant followed the law, but the new covenant follows the law giver. Get that? That is so, so exciting. The old covenant, you follow the law. But what he wants us to do is to follow. Jesus came and died, and now he wants us to follow the law giver. Okay? Isn't the person who made the law much better than the law? So what you are supposed to do in this new covenant is be led by the Holy Spirit, not the law. The law is hard, rigid. Do this, do this, do this. You break one law and you're guilty of breaking the whole law. And remember, it was for the Jews. Unless you are a Jew, you were never, ever, ever supposed to follow the old covenant, the Old Testament. That was a covenant sealed in blood for the Jews. Okay? Born again people were given the Holy Spirit as he sealed us. He made our spirit new and alive, and he joined us with Jesus. He made us one with God. I'm sorry, I just get excited at all these revelations God gives me. He made us one spirit with God. God lives inside of us. The kingdom, the power of God lives inside of us. And we are now to follow the Holy Spirit, not the law. We are following the lawgiver, not the law. And the lawgiver is so much better than the law. The lawgiver is personal. Instead of saying, hey, don't look at that girl, don't look at that guy, you're going to commit adultery, don't do that. No, 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 no. He says, hey, listen here. You know what? Your husband works really hard today. Why don't you give him a foot massage tonight when he gets home? And you know what? You know that necklace he gave you? He really spent hours looking for it. He looked for that really hard because he loves you so much. And you didn't think he did. And you know, he's so much better. The Holy Spirit is so much better than the law. The lawgiver is better than the law. And he writes it in your heart. You know what's wrong. You know what's right. Because the Holy Spirit, it'll be like when you're married to your spouse. And if you did something that hurts his feelings, it hurts you. You are sad. Or even you and your child, if you did something that hurt your child, if you said something that hurt their feelings, like you looked at this ugly little picture that they drew and you say, yeah, it's all right, and they spent hours drawing it, you should tell them what a wonderful picture it is. You hurt their feelings. Well, then your feelings are hurt. I remember one particular time, and this is so crazy. My daughter gave me a flower, a rose, and she hardly had any money at all. And I told her on the phone not to spend any money on me. And she thought it was so precious to spend her money on a rose to give to me for a present. Well, I said, you shouldn't have spent that money on me because flowers aren't that important to me. You're more important. Well, her feelings were hurt because she spent some money on a flower for me. And to me, a flower wasn't that important. She was more important. So I cried because my feelings were hurt because I hurt her feelings. And I was more upset than she was. I could even cry now thinking about it. So that's how it is with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is in love with you. The Holy Spirit is in you. He's the lawgiver. He doesn't say, do this, do that, don't do this, don't do that. He'll say, hey, go down this street, turn right. Hey, I'm partners with you. Let me help you run your business. Let me help you make you prosperous and have success. Let me show you how to get that husband that you're looking at. Yeah, he's the guy for you. Let me show you how to get him. That is the Holy Spirit. Don't follow the law. Follow the lawgiver. Okay, now back to my original thing. What is the difference between what the Holy Spirit does and what the angels do? He told me all I got through today was Matthew. But in the book of Matthew, he showed me the Holy Spirit lives inside of you. The Holy Spirit is power, is the power of God, the presence of God, the voice of God. And he teaches you, he guides you, and he directs you. But what I found that the angels do is the angels give you messages. They show you which way to go. If you look at the whole Bible, Old and New Testament, angels gave direction. They gave messages. They ministered to you. And the Holy Spirit is a teacher, a comforter, and a guide. He's always there. You can lay hands on anything or anyone and manifest God's presence and manifest healing. And so part of what I'm getting at is the Holy Spirit, it says the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. And where is the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is inside of you. Okay? So the Holy Spirit, the kingdom of God is inside of you in power. And sometimes when you hear that voice in your head and it doesn't sound like you, it's okay because it's God. You know what God will talk to you, and sometimes it'll sound like you, and sometimes it'll sound not like you. Begin to trust the Holy Spirit inside of you, but also realize that you are a spirit being who lives in a body and has a soul. So you should be able to experience the spirit realm, and I'm not talking about the occult, because who created the spirit realm? My daddy God, my daddy, who is a spirit being. My brother Jesus, a spirit being. The Holy Spirit, my lover, my friend, my comforter, a spirit being. And I am a spirit being joined to them in one. So the occult has stolen the spiritual realm, the signs and the symbols. Those belong to God. They stole it. They twisted it. They distorted it. They're being led by demons. Okay? We rule in the spirit realm. And we should be able to experience it. The church has gotten away from it. They've gotten into making everything about service and everything about obedience. instead of and going to church instead of being the church. We should be out there wherever we go. I have fun. Wherever we go, you lay hands on the sick and you heal them. All you have to do is believe. It's not your power. It's God's power. You just believe. So wherever you go, you should be able to manifest God's power. You should be having fun. Service, God said to me today, and I thought this was really cool. He said, service is not necessarily going and feeding the hungry, visiting people in prison, or working at a clinic or whatever. He said, service, he says, I did service when I walked the earth. And he asks questions. He said, what did I do when I walked the earth? And I said, I don't see the service that we call service today. He says, no. He says, the service I did was I serviced the people by healing them, casting out demons, cleansing them of leopards. That was my service, and that should be your service. So you have the power in you to change the world around you, to change the atmosphere. You are a spirit being, and I'm so excited because the book that I am walking through right now and God is creating in me, and I am writing and will be published. I don't know when it'll be done, but I'm living it, and I'm so excited. It's called Punching Holes in Darkness. It's about how to walk in your true identity in the spirit realm. The spirit realm created the natural realm. Okay. So it is all about walking in dominion and authority on this earth. And it's really exciting. I'm not sure when it's going to be out. I have pictures of it on my Facebook account, but I try not to spill too much of the beans. It's a work in progress. It's happening. I'm living it. Actually, I lived all my books. That's how they became books, is because I live them and I know them and experience them. Anyway, so the difference between what God, the Holy Spirit does in you and the angels do in you is the fact that you are a spirit being. Angels are spirit beings and they're out here. They're the ones that bring body parts to you when you pray and lay hands on people. They're the ones that give you the messages. The Holy Spirit is the one that, gives you the authority and the power and the dominion from the inside out. And the angels are on the outside. And that God's just saying that to me now. So, oh, that's really cool. So the Holy Spirit is the power that works from the inside of you coming out to affect the world. And the angels are the ones that minister to you on the outside. They set up situations, change situations, line up things, change things, and so on. So my name is RobinBremer.net is my website. Share this with your Facebook friends. Share this with your social media sites. And I just want to set people free. If you don't like what I'm saying, that's fine. Go listen to some other teacher, preacher, prophet, whatever. But I'm sharing, because I'm called to the office of a prophet, I am sharing my life of what God has called me to share to you. And that's all I'm doing, is I am just wanting to get you excited about the things of God, wanting to share with you the power, the peace, the presence, the supernaturalness of God, the fellowship of God with you, like God shares with me, so you can walk in that same thing. But if you don't believe it, you can ask me questions if you want to know the truth and want to believe it. But if you're a naysayer and you're a doubter and you want to call me a false prophet, get so exciting when people do that, because I know I'm making a difference in the spiritual realm, because the demons get mad and they push people to say, religious people to say stuff. But anyway, go somewhere else if you don't like me. But share this with your friends, social media site, and go to my website and check out some of my stuff. But I just want you to get on fire for God. I want you to be a revival. I want you to explode from the inside out and get so on fire for God that you are healing the sick, raising the dead, cleansing the leopards, seeing angels, seeing the host of heaven. Look in the clouds. They're all around us. So I'll talk to you some other time. Have a blessed day.